Right, basically, we'll go to these undiscovered locations first. We'll discover these three, and then go to the well. Okay?
Out of my way. Out of my way.
There's Roach. Oh, there he is. Hello.
Let's go.
This undiscovered location first. Because these can actually give you chests and stuff. So it's good to actually go to them first. Oh, hello. Donors! Yes! Hold on. I think these are bombs that are hard. Oh shit. There's another one. There's another one, there we are. There we are. Done. Shoot these guys. Oh, good. See? That's why I like playing on the harder difficulty. Cause it's a challenge. Oh, I can't get that. Okay. Vial. Silk. Oh, okay. Hello. Item diagram. Take diagrams to craft them with proper skills to have them. Craft diagram for you. Go on that page. Okay. Right. Cool. What are you doing, Roach? There's another one. So we've done that one. I'm going to this one. Hold on, we got some. I think we got beastery entries. Drowners. Necrophase oil and Igni. Oh, Igni! Right, so we're going to Igni. So, drowners, when at the water's edge, you gotta be quiet. First of all, so as not to scare the fish. Second, so you don't attract drowners. Yannick of Blaviken Fisherman. A drowner resembles a corpse dredged from the bottom of a pond. It is sickly blue or green in colour, with slime and sludge oozing out of every pore and the acrid stench of rot wafting off of it. That is why it is often thought drowners, along with their more dangerous cousins, rodnicks, muck mixers, and drowned dead, arise from the bodies of those who drown in shallow water, lost travellers falling into bogs, children who swim too far from the shore, or, in the case of rodnicks, inebriated peasants who stumble off narrow swamp trails. So these guys are actually vulnerable to Igni and Necrophage oil. I actually used Ard and I thought they would knock them down, but they're invulnerable to that. So it's Igni and Necrophage oil. Cool. I think we've got something though. Do we not? Do we not get a quest from that? thinking of that. Yeah. Need to compare. 9% critical hit damage bonus to 10%. Okay, you know what? I need to repair that before I can use it. Can I repair that once I use it? Depending on my resistance to piercing damage. Okay, but you know what? I'm gonna do this contract and then repair it and then clip these. That's a glyph of Ard. Upgrade, place an empty socket on a piece of equipment to improve its traits. I'm just a repair kit, okay. And drink. Hold on. Crafting, here we are. Chest armor. So we need cured leather, leather scraps, and wire for this. Warrior's leather jacket. 30 armor. How much should I go for this one? Right. Makes him look fat. Okay, that. Cure the raccoon leather. Leather scraps, of course. Got a silver sword.
Wow.
Holy crap. Cool, can't make that yet, so let's go to the next one.
That's it, Roach.
Oh shit, hold on. Yeah. Oh crap. Another one? Oh, there's another one, that's why. There we are. Blood. Yeah. We've got location right there. Right. Roach, come here. Where are we going next? Hold on. To this one. Now watch. Good man. Good boy.
Not so fast, Roach.
Are you fucking serious? This will take ages. Oh, Come on. Come on, bear. This bear has so many one shot. I actually noticed that. Quinn, I need Quinn back. Oh yeah. Wow. Yay! You've gained an ability point first because of the character funnel to run a new ability. Nice. Alright. That was very... That was very interesting to play that much. Wow, that fight was epic.